At the Money Show Toronto, investing in ETFs is a major theme. And who better than Steve Hawkins, President and CEO of Horizons ETFs, to talk to us about investing in this innovative product. Steve, welcome to Small Cap Power.
Thank you for having me, Vasudha.
So Horizons ETFs has always been at the forefront of introducing innovative ETFs, and you were the world's first marijuana ETF. Why marijuana as a sector in particular?
Well, you know, it was a very new and young, evolving asset class that we thought was very exciting for investors. There were marijuana companies becoming part of the news stories almost every single day. We actually started work well in advance of when we launched the ETF, almost a year in advance, because we thought there would be a huge, tremendous growth in this industry. Yeah. And, you know, when we first invested in marijuana, you know, there was really only like 12 different companies we could invest in. Within a year, we had 100 different companies that we could invest in, right? This was a huge booming industry itself.
Right. So you started with HMMJ, and since then you've launched two more. Take us through those products.
Yeah, so shortly after we launched, after we saw the success of HMMJ, we launched HMJR, which is a junior global marijuana companies ETF. So we see cannabis growing rapidly around the world. You know, although Canada was the first developed country to legalize recreational marijuana, now marijuana, either medical or recreational or both, is approved in 43 different countries around the world. So this is a very growing global industry. And as we see it, we needed to sort of expand the reach of other products and allow investors to get access to global marijuana companies. So we are investing in Australia, we're investing in Israel, we're investing in Colombia, just to name a few. Like, we see cannabis as a tremendous growth sector.
Okay. The audience coming today at the Money Show is a very mature audience. How are you going to impress upon them about ETFs over mutual funds, and that too focused on marijuana?
Well, ETFs have become sort of the mainstay of investors at getting access to whatever sort of investment strategies they want to do nowadays. It was always traditional mutual funds in the past. That is no longer the case. You know, we've been sponsoring the Money Show since it first came to Toronto. We were the only ETF provider here up until like 3 years ago. And now, you know, the other ETF providers got jealous of us being the only sponsors here. So now we have 10 different ETF providers here at the Money Show, and ETFs are on the agenda almost every half an hour for investors to talk about. Right. ETFs are prolific. It is a changing way of investing, and we're here to just to help promote ETFs, help allow investors to get access to how they want to invest.
Right. For the next 12 months, what's in the pipeline at Horizons?
We're just content. Right now, we're going through a significant reorg of our synthetic suite of ETFs, where we have a tax-efficient suite of products, which allows individuals to defer tax. It doesn't avoid taxes completely, but you get to defer tax. And if you can defer taxes, why wouldn't you? So with the suite of products, because of changes to the federal budget, we have to go through a reorganization. So that is very high on our to-do list, because we want to continue to offer a tax-efficient product line to Canadian investors, yeah. And we need to make some changes to do that.
Right. Last year when we met at the Money Show in 2018, ETFs had broken the record of mutual funds for the first time in a decade. They had outsold. Yeah. Do you see that they're going to beat that target again?
So that trend has continued so far in 2019, and we really believe, you know, 2017 was the last year that mutual funds will outsell ETFs. So 2018, we took over. 2019, we continued to lead the charge. We've seen the trend in the U.S., like significant dispersion between ETF sales and mutual fund redemptions. It's very difficult in Canada because the banks control distribution, and they really, you know, when you go in a bank branch every single day and your teller says, okay, here's your $200, but do you want to buy a mutual fund? Mm-hmm. They're not trying to sell you an ETF. They're trying to sell mutual funds. Mutual funds will continue to be sold very actively by the banks here. Right. So the uptake of mutual funds will continue to go down because ETFs are really taking over. But mutual funds will never die in Canada, whereas I believe mutual funds are going to die in the U.S. very quickly.
Great talking to you, Steve. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you for having me today.